Good morning, children. In the last class, we have studied about useful microorganisms. In today's class, we'll discuss about harmful microorganisms. How the microorganisms are harmful to human beings, animals, as well as plants, we have to study in this class. Mainly, this microorganism causes different diseases in different organism. It may be in animals, plants, or human beings. That's why they are very harmful to the organism. What are those diseases or those things we'll discuss in today's class? I think you observed the video given by me. Okay, in that video you can see the different diseases caused by microorganisms. Again, I will discuss once again about the diseases caused by those microorganisms. Microorganism causes diseases in animals, plants, as well as in human beings. The disease causing microorganisms or disease causing microbes or disease causing germs are called as pathogens. Disease causing microorganisms are called pathogens. These pathogens enter our body. These pathogens enter our body through air, water, as well as food or by the physical contact with the infected person. Pathogens enter our body through air, water, and food or direct contact with the infected person. These are the ways through which the microorganisms or pathogens enter the body. They enter the body and they cause some of the diseases. First of all, we'll discuss about what is communicable disease. What is the meaning of communicable disease? Microbial diseases that can spread from an infected person to healthy person. Microbial diseases that will spread from infected person to healthy person through air, water, food or physical contact are called communicable diseases. Examples of communicable diseases are cholera, common cold and chickenpox, tuberculosis, etc. These are the examples for communicable diseases. Cholera, common cold, chickenpox, tuberculosis. These are the examples for communicable diseases. When a person is suffering from a common cold, when a person is suffering from common cold, he sneezes. During that time, a different moisture content of droplets come out from his body. They are having some of the viruses. They will enter through the air. And if any healthy person breathes that type of air, that microbes, the infected microbes, pathogens will enter into his body and he may get infection. Like this, what happened, the common cold will transfer through air. And some of the animals as well as insects are the carriers of diseases, disease-causing microbes. Common disease-causing carrier, microbe carrier is a housefly. Housefly is a common carrier of disease-causing microbe. Because it sits on, animal excreta as well as garbages, and those disease-causing pathogens or disease-causing microbes or pathogens stick to their body, and they bring that one, and they, when they sit on uncovered food item, and they will, uncovered food item will be pathogenic, that will be infected by that. Pathogens are transferred to the uncovered food item. When a healthy person eats that uncovered food or contaminated food, that microbes will enter into the body and that causes different diseases. That's why it is advised that a person should eat a covered food, and always the food should be covered. because uncovered food will be contaminated and they may cover some of the diseases. They may cause some of the diseases. And another one very important carrier, that is female Anopheles mosquito. Usually mosquitoes will breed in water, and that's why we should not allow the water to collect in our surrounding, because they breed in the water rapidly, and that's why you should not allow the water to collect in our surrounding, and you have to keep your surrounding clean, because if the water is standing nearby, then mosquitoes will be more. They will carry the protozoa that is responsible for malaria disease. That is, name of that protozoa is Plasmodium vivax. That's a protozoa that will be in the female Anopheles mosquito when it bites, and it will be transmitted to healthy person. It is a parasite of malaria. Okay, malaria, that disease caused by this Plasmodium vivax, that's a protozoa that is transmitted through Anopheles mosquito. Don't think that Anopheles mosquito will mosquito is responsible for the malaria disease. Plasmodium vivax protozoa is responsible for malaria, but it is a carrier of that protozoa. Okay, next, another one, Aedes mosquito, that is responsible, that is a carrier of Aedes mosquito, that is a carrier of dengue virus. Dengue virus, that is carried or transmitted with the help of water, Aedes mosquito. Okay, these are the some of the common carriers, that is housefly, female Anopheles mosquito, and Aedes mosquito. These are the carriers of disease causing microbes. And next we will discuss about some of the diseases caused by microbes in a human being. Common diseases caused by human beings. Okay. Human diseases caused by microbes. There are different diseases. They have given some of the diseases here. First one we have to discuss tuberculosis. That is caused by microbe, that is bacteria. Bacterial disease, it is a bacterial disease. Mode of transmission, that will transmitted through air. And how we can prevent these diseases, all these. Next one, measles. That is a viral disease that can be spread through air. And another one is chickenpox, that can be that is spread by with help of virus. That is a viral disease that can be spread transmitted with the help of air as well as water contact with a person. And next, polio, that is a viral disease, and that is transmitted with the help of air as well as water. For all these three diseases, tuberculosis, measles, chickenpox, and polio, what you have to do, how you can prevent these diseases, that is keep the patient in complete isolation. The person should be in isolation. Keep the personal belongings of the patient away from others. You have to keep the personal belongings of an infected person away from others. And vaccination to be given to suitable age, or given at suitable age. Vaccination should be given at a suitable age. Next one, very important. This tuberculosis is a bacterial disease. These three are measles, chickenpox, and polio. These three are viral diseases. You have to name viral diseases, bacterial diseases, like that. Next, how you have to remember preventive measures also. Next, cholera, that is caused by bacteria, that is transmitted with help of water and food. And typhoid, that is a bacterial disease that is transmitted through water. And how we can prevent these two diseases, cholera and typhoid, that is maintain personal hygiene and good sanitary habits. That means we have to keep ourselves clean, first of all. Consume cooked food and drink boiled water, and vaccination. These are the preventive measures of cholera and typhoid. That means, first of all, you should be very clean. And next, consume cooked food and boiled water, drinking water. And next, vaccination should be given at a suitable age. Next, another one very important, that is hepatitis A. That is a viral disease that is transmitted through water and drink. For this preventive measure, that is drink boiled water and vaccination should be given, should be taken. That is mode of transmission through water and it's a viral disease. Next, very important disease, that is malaria, that is caused by protozoa. The name of that protozoa is Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax, it causes a disease called as a malaria, that is transmitted through mosquito, female Anopheles mosquito. Understood? I think clear. It is mode of transmission. Disease is transmitted by mosquito, that is caused by protozoa. Name of that protozoa is Plasmodium vivax. That causes a disease that is called as malaria. What you have to do? What are the preventive measures for this? Use mosquito net or mosquito curtain and repellents. Spray insecticide and control breeding of mosquitoes by not allowing water to collect in the surrounding. What you have to do? You have to should not allow the water to collect in our surrounding. Stagnant water should be avoided in our surrounding because mosquitoes will breed in a collected water. That's why these are the preventive measures. You can use mosquito repellents or mosquito curtains or mosquito net to avoid the mosquitoes. Because it is a carrier of that protozoa that causes malaria. But here, these are the human diseases caused by microorganism. And not only it causes diseases in human, it also causes diseases in animal. That is anthrax, that is a bacterial disease that is caused by caused in animal. That is a bacterial disease. That anthrax, that is disease is caused by the bacteria. Name of that bacteria is Bacillus anthracis. Name of that bacteria is Bacillus anthracis, that was discovered by Robert Koch in the year 1876. You have to collect the information about the scientist Robert Koch. It is also one activity. You have to add that in the info sheet. You have to collect information about Robert Koch. And he introduced that bacteria that causes anthrax, that is Bacillus anthracis. And next, another one disease, that is foot and mouth disease, that is caused by virus in the animal. Virus causes a disease that is called as foot and mouth disease in animals. And this microorganism, again they causes some of the diseases in plants. They are very important. First one is citrus canker, that is citrus canker in lemon plant you will come across. It's a bacterial disease that will be transmitted through air. And in higher classes, you will study about detail. Next, another one is rust of wheat. And it is a fungal disease. It is caused by fungi. It will spread through or transmitted through air and seeds. Next, another one is yellow vein mosaic bindi. That is viral disease. And it is caused by, it is transmitted with the help of insect. Here, the leaves of the citrus plant or a lemon plant will become folded, and here some of the here some holes will become across in the leaves of that wheat plant. They will become yellow color, and here yellow vein, here yellow color plant will be appear. There are some characteristics of these plant diseases you will study in the higher classes. And you have to remember all these diseases, human diseases, plant diseases, as well as animal diseases caused by microorganism. Because of all these harmful nature, microorganisms are considered as foe. Foe means they are enemies to the environment. Okay, that's why sometimes they are harmful, sometimes they are useful. Okay, this is about the harmful nature as well as users we have studied in the last class. These are the harmful microorganisms, harmful effects of microorganisms. If you have any doubt, you can ask. You can go through this, you cannot see here properly. You can go to the textbook, you can see this chart clearly, and I have given already this activity to write in the A4 sheet. A4 sheet. Okay, I think you've done that one. Okay, thank you. If you have any doubt, you can ask.